You know the logo, you know Rob Dyrdek. Maybe you even owned a pair of DCs. But did you know that DC is actually a billion-dollar company? Not million, billion dollars. It's one of the most important skateboarding companies in the world, and they actually made some pretty dope shoes. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look at the story behind DC shoes and some of their most iconic silhouettes. Welcome back, everybody, and if you're new here, my name is Brian, and my brother Nacho and I make videos on sneaker history and all things related to sneaker culture. So if you're into sneakers, then you might want to consider subscribing to this channel because we make videos like this all the time and you're not going to want to miss an upload. All right, guys, with that out of the way, let's get into the history of DC shoes. The early 90s was ripe with skateboarding startup companies. The underground sport was finally getting its shine in the limelight, and savvy businessmen and women saw an opportunity to enter the young market. Back in 1991, DC founders Ken Block and Damon Way met in an algebra class at a community college in Southern California. And this is where the first iteration of DC was born. Their partnership birthed the clothing company 8Ball, maybe the first ever crossover between streetwear and skateboarding culture. 8Ball was short-lived due to the discovery of another brand called 8Ball, which actually had the name trademarked. Determined to keep going, Damon and Ken started Blunt Snowboarding Magazine and a jeans company called Jors. Jors would eventually evolve from a jeans brand to a full-on clothing company. Are any of you guys old enough to remember Jors Clothing? Jors Clothing was a success, and with the newly acquired capital, Ken and Damon saw an opportunity to break into the skateboarding footwear space. DC Shoes was born. Now we know what DC stands for, Jors Clothing. You see, back in the early to mid 90s, skate shoes weren't really thought of as performance shoes. Skate shoes kind of lacked innovation. DC wanted to be the innovative skate shoe brand, the Nike of the skateboarding world. Let's talk about the logo for a minute. The original designer for the DC logo was Ken Block, but unfortunately, they ran into trademark issues real quick. The first DC logo was a C inside of an elongated letter D spelling out DC in a circle shape. They were quickly hit with a complaint from the clothing company Champion, who thought the logo was too similar to their iconic Champion C logo. It then evolved into the logo we know today, but you see that little star right there on the right? It originally had 5 points. Apparently, Converse reached out to DC and told them that they had a trademark for a 5-point star on footwear and forced DC to change it. The company cleverly changed it to a 7-point star, and that's the logo that we see today on most of DC's products. DC's first foray into footwear began with the creation of Damon Way's brother, Danny Way's first signature model shoe, the Danny Way 1, also known as the DW1. A simple skate shoe with a suede upper, a cup sole, and a thick padded tongue that was so reminiscent of that era. Danny Way and the Canadian pro skater Colin McKay were the first two riders on DC's team. Colin McKay's pro shoe was also one of DC's first footwear products to release. Over the next several years, DC continued to add riders to the team, some of which included Rob Dyrdek, Josh Kalis, Mike Carroll, Rick Howard, Keith Huffnagel, rest in peace, and Scott Johnston. All of them went on to become legends and pioneers in the skateboard industry. In 1996, DC hired Sung Choi as a footwear designer. Sung had never designed a shoe before, but the first shoe he made would become the most iconic DC shoe of all time, the Lynx. Released in 1997, Choi wanted to slim down the puffy, bulky look that skate shoes had back then. He also wanted them to be functional as skate shoes and as chill shoes. I can remember watching Brian Wenning's part in the DC video, and I was floored when I saw how dope he looked skating in the Lynx, and I had to have him. Coming up as a skater kid, my homies and I would skate in Lynx and keep a fresh pair in our backpack or in the trunk of our car just to kick it in. It was super common back then in skateboarding culture to double up on a pair of shoes if you could afford it. One for skating and one for chilling. The shoe was retroed by DC recently, and it's still highly sought after by collectors. Another iconic shoe from DC is the Kalis, Josh Kalis' signature shoe. Josh Kalis is one of the most stylish skaters of all time. He and fellow DC skater at the time, Stevie Williams, whose signature shoe we will discuss in a minute, are responsible for forever connecting Love Park and Philly skateboard culture to DC shoes. Love Park was a mecca for skateboarding at the height of DC's popularity and relevance in the skateboard world. At least, when I was a kid, it was my dream to skate at Love Park. Unfortunately, the city demolished the parts of the park that made it so good for skateboarding. Now it's just some lame park with a love sign for Instagram photo opportunities. Have you ever been to Love Park? Did you guys skate there, or are any of you guys from Philly? Leave a comment down below. The Kalis went through four different iterations. The OG version, which is my favorite, features a mix of mesh, synthetic leather, and a suede upper that sits on top of a wavy cup sole. The shoe is super puffy and has tons of padding inside, making it perfect for skateboarding. DC took inspiration from the OG upper and made the Kalis Lite, a less puffier version of the shoe. They also modernized the silhouette with a Kalis and a Kalis Volk. Vulcanized sole shoes are what most modern skate shoes use these days because it improves board feel. Personally though, I still prefer to skate in puffy skate shoes, but you know, vulcanized skate shoes are also good. I think I'm just kind of old. What would DC's heritage be without Stevie Williams? Also designed by Sung Choi, Stevie Williams' shoe is obviously inspired by the Jordan 12. I mean, just look at the way there's a layer wrapping around the toe box and the sidewall of the shoe. DC recently retroed the shoe a few years ago in its OG shape and also did a slimmed down version of it. Last year, LA streetwear brand Rocket made their own version of the Williams OG, which featured what looks like a neoprene sock on the inside. I'm not sure how I feel about those. Stevie Williams is one of the most iconic skaters in the game and he's still killing it to this day. If you guys don't follow him on Instagram, you should. It's super dope. He like skates his park in Koreatown in LA every day and he like shreds and Jordans and Air Maxes and Off-Whites. It's super dope. In 2001, DC officially launched the Artist Project Sneaker Initiative. Many people don't know this, but DC was the first ever footwear brand to do collaborations with artists and other brands. Way before Nike and way before all the hyped up collabs that we know today, DC made collabs with the likes of Supreme, artists like Kaws and Obey. This DC Torsion Supreme collab was made in 1999. This has to be the first ever Supreme collab. Correct me if I'm wrong though, leave a comment below. Pro skater and serial entrepreneur Rob Dyrdek, who you might know from the MTV show Ridiculousness, was a huge contributor to the explosive growth of DC shoes. In 2003, DC released a DC video, one of the most important skate videos in modern skateboarding culture. Before Rob Dyrdek's part, there was this skit with him and his bodyguard Big Black, which would later be made into a full production show on MTV called Robin Big. You might have watched it. I grew up watching it. Maybe you grew up watching it. Do you guys remember Robin Big? With Dyrdek rocking DC's apparel on the show, it really made DC more of a mainstream brand. Now, Rob also had his own signature shoes, but when doing research for this video, I couldn't really find that much information about them, so I kind of hit a wall here. I believe he had a signature shoe for every year that he skated for DC, which is a lot because he skated for them until 2016. Here's a video of Rob in 2009 talking about his 15th shoe. Yeah, 15th shoe in 2009. So yeah, he must have had a ton of shoes, but I just can't seem to find any decent information on them.
Let's talk about inspiration. This is my very first professional shoe with DC shoes. Now, it seems incredibly plain and simple, but you know, 15 years ago, this was like pushing the boundaries of athletic design. And to name the shoe, we named it the RD9501AW for Rob Dyrdek, 1995-01 first shoe, AW Alien Workshop, my board sponsor. So when it came time to do my 15th shoe, I wanted to sort of pay tribute to the design of my first shoe. So that's why, you know, this is basically sort of a retro high top version of this exact design, you know, carrying the same lines that come all the way around, you know.
Over the next several years, DC released a plethora of models like the Court Graphic, which was one of their best sellers, the Pure, the Manateca, the Legacy OG, which to me looks a lot like an Air Max 95 or an Air Max 97. DC's catalog is so large and there's so many shoes that came out that I can't find any information about. So that's why I want to recommend the channel Golden Era Collector to you guys. This dude is a huge vintage DC collector and his videos are super dope. He's a wealth of knowledge and be sure to check out his IG and his channel if you want to get into DC a little deeper. I'd really like to go a little bit deeper on the history of DC in the future, but there's only so much research we can do as a two-man band. But hey, if you want to learn more about the history of sneakers, we put together this playlist for you here to my left on all the sneaker history videos we've done. We've done the Air Max 95, we've done Nike SB, we've done the Air Max 97, the Jordan 1, the Jordan 11. So go ahead and click on that and I will see you over in those videos. And thank you guys so much for watching. Yeah, click on that and I'll see you over in those videos. Peace.